All right, walking out the door, loading the kayaks. Reloading here.
Discussing the fact that we might be overloaded here before we even start.
So we're about 2.5 kilometers in, we're just passing by Petrie Island.
Making our first pit stop, about 10K in. Quigley Hill boat launch is right across there. About 3 hours in, about 16K. In line with Rockland right now. Here we are at the Thurso Ferry, about 5 kilometers down from Rockland. We got a few more kilometers to go before we start hitting some of the uninhabited islands we're going to try and camp night one at. First one up after is Parker Island. It is not looking promising. Got Marcus on the other side of the island on the Quebec side, going down that side to see if there's anything better looking over there, but I have a feeling this is going to be a no-go and we're going to have to push on to Île de Chevalier. So Parker Island, not a place to camp. All right, so weather is starting to turn on us. We got possible thunder showers rolling in.
Really reedy, high grass, high banks. The parts that are low and accessible are wet and unprotected from wake and possible fluctuations in the water levels.
Got one spot on the far end of it towards Montreal. Quebec side, a little clearing here. Good for camping, someone's had a fire. See behind us there, storm's rolling in hard, so we gotta set up quick.
All right, tearing down day one. So this is the campsite. Looks like someone tends it, cuts the grass back. Inlet protection here, get some good wildlife. Have tons of birds on the little island over there. We're tearing down, all done. Gonna be on the water by like 9. And just wanna highlight the site again and point out that it's really important, especially if you're guerrilla camping, but always, to leave the site as good or better than you found it. Keeps everyone happy and keeps people from complaining about guerrilla campers.
Made a pit stop here.
Nice little dock. Outhouse. Just looks like a public boat launch and dock.
We're about 13 kilometers in today. About 3 hours. Trying to do probably another 30 today. Decent day. Some sun. Calm water. Current's really not doing much today. We decided to cut up the Ontario side and avoid Parc de Plaisir, which is all up in there. The other side of this piece of land, this peninsula. Over there we got Île de Ruissin. We were originally considering this one maybe even for yesterday, but now we can officially check it off the list as a contender for camping. All right, we're just going by the Fairmont Montebello. Shout outs to my cousin Travis and his wife Leanne, who were married and stayed at this hotel a couple years ago. So we just took off from the Montebello Marina and boat launch. Good thing to know, you can get a water fill up, you can get a bathroom break, you can dock a kayak for free for a bit, And for $20 per tent a night, you can get a campsite too, right on the water. So we have decided to push on. Still a lot of daylight left. So we're pushing up to L'Original. Saw a good beach there that looks like it'll be a good gorilla campsite, but good to know. Montebello Marina has camping, has water, has bathrooms. Good stop for a break or for the night.
Waters don't look so bad, sky doesn't look so bad. Found our second camping spot for the night. Nice little beach. Some people seem to have done a couple little fires on. So what you don't see is the fact that we just went through probably an hour and a half of giant wind and chop. And for the last 5 or 10 minutes, we just got dumped on. Literally, as we found this spot, the rain just let go on us. So got a little drenched, and so did our new camping site. But overall, this looks like another little gem that we found. Just a little upriver of L'Original on the Ontario side. We were trying to hit a boat launch and what looked like a big beach, probably another couple kilometers down, but we found this and it looks perfect for the night. So we're gonna call it here at just under 40 kilometers for the day. Camp behind me. That's the way we came from. And that's the way we're going. Starting day two, a little later than day one, but needed the rest and it's nice to take a breather. As you can see, site is as nice, not a little cleaner than we found it. We got rid of some glass. Estimating maybe about 25 kilometers downriver. We'll be passing Hawkesbury shortly and then it's a little past that to Voyageur Provincial Park.
Right here too.
3 total for the paddle for me.
It was really everything in one and then water.
The way she's only seen one kayak do it before.
Yeah,
I'll the other way is worse.
All right, we just completed portaging the Carillion lock, which is currently broken and not being fixed until the end of this month. We didn't do all our research, I guess. Overall, wasn't too bad. We were able to do it in under an hour. So overall, not a huge delay on the day. And some out of the boat exercises at the horse right now. All right, here we go, pushing down. Next stop, isn't it also like Carillion Island? Carillion Island, giant migratory bird sanctuary. That'll be our next destination. And goodbye to the Carillion lock. And there's a little island up there in the middle that we are heading for, called Ilogram. It is pretty grueling out there right now. There is no shade. That was a long stretch and that sun is just beating down. We finally made it to Ilogram. I don't think we're gonna be camping here unless he finds something coming around, but I just found the shade and I am stopping here for a bit. Little shade here. Yeah, and any no real camping? What did this, was there a sign?
No, there was a sign. It said, it was French. And it said like, three hunters, defense 2020.
Clear stretch on the water, no clouds.
Amazing hot sun. Thank you.
So this is the last night of the Ottawa to Montreal kayaking adventure. We stayed at Voyager last night. Today we did about 31 and a half kilometers more downriver. Got turned away from a couple of places there in Hudson. Threatened with some fines there. The beach was closed. It's all private property going down that coast. Right here, just past this corner here, is our property. But all of this up in here seems to be unoccupied land, so we are just trying to stay down beach here so that we don't disturb anybody. We haven't pitched the tents yet. We're gonna wait until right before dark, then probably come in right here. We've been just down here behind the tree, had our last supper. A lot of wake here, but doesn't seem to come too high. So this will be the last stop, and then tomorrow morning we just have maybe 10-15K. We're gonna cut across, make our way to St. Anne, where we're getting picked up. And that'll be it for the trip. Made it to Montreal. So here we are, we did it. We are in St. Anne.
St. Anne de Bellevue.
St. Anne de Bellevue. The far western tip of Montreal Island. Probably have more than enough time and energy to push into Montreal, but this is a good place to call it. This was the plan, this was the rendezvous. So our ride's on the way and we're just gonna start unloading and yeah, calling it. This is it.
All right, man.
That's it. Good stuff.